gives this woman in marriage? Our couple today is a very special couple, special to us all, special to their families, special to their friends, certainly special to one another, special to me, and special to the Lord. I haven't known Amanda and her family very long. I'm getting to know them better, and the better that I get to know them, the more that I like them. Now, I've known Justin and his family for many, many years. And I know that both Justin and Amanda were raised to revere the Lord and to strive to fulfill the three great commands that the Lord has given us. Number one, love God with all your heart. Number two, Jesus referred to it as the new command, love one another. That's the church family, with the same love that I had for you. And then number three, love your neighbor as yourself. Amanda was raised on the Lord. And when she was a small child, her parents would, at bedtime, they would get with her, and they would read to her, and they would sing with her, and they would pray with her. One night, Dad was pretty tired. Amanda wanted somebody to read to her, and Dad said, "Amanda, I'm just too tired, hon. We'll pray with him." "Well, I'm just too tired." And finally, she said, "Well, Dad, read the Bible to me." And I guess I don't have to say that she was read to that evening. Amanda speaks of Justin's patience and his gentleness and his generosity. I've never heard her say a lot about his courage. Back when Justin was in about the third or fourth grade, he was the ball boy for Highland High School football. And in fact, his coach Hill is here today. So we were playing Piggott, home of Ernest Hemingway, in a football game. And Justin, being the ball boy, went to retrieve a football, and on his way back towards the team, he heard some of the Piggott boys talk about some terrible things that they were going to do to player number 12. So Justin ran up to Coach Hill and started pulling on his britches leg, saying, "Coach, coach." Coach Hill, of course, he's trying to coach the game, and he says, "Go on, Justin, get away, leave me alone." "Coach, these guys from Piggott are planning on doing something awful to number 12. Coach said, "Don't bother me, Justin. I'm trying to coach the game. Go on." He said, "But coach, they're going to do something bad to number 12. Coach said, "Go on, Justin." And Justin said, "But coach, I'm number 12. And then there was the time that he got into college ball. And he goes to Harding University, and they are the Bison. And each player gets his picture taken with the family, his family, and with the Bison. Justin, being the man of courage that he is, was afraid of the Bison and made his mother stand by the Bison instead of himself. A lot of other stories I could tell you, but I'd get in trouble if I did. But I will say this. He is a man of courage. And he is patient. And he is kind. And he's generous. When my son was leaving the country for a while, Justin was riding in the car with him, and Justin reached in his pocket and pulled out a fistful of money that he'd worked for all summer and saved. Jacob said, "Justin, I don't want your money." And Justin said, "No, I want you to have it." So we're gathered here today in the sight of God to join together this very special couple in holy matrimony. Justin and Amanda, the institution that you are entering into is the oldest institution in the world. It was created and ordained by our Heavenly Father in the Garden of Eden with the very first man and the first woman, Adam and Eve. From Genesis chapter 2, the Bible says that the Lord caused the man to fall into a deep sleep, and while he was sleeping, he took one of the man's ribs and closed up the place with flesh. And then the Lord God made a woman from the rib that he had taken out of the man, and he brought her to the man. And the man said, "This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, for she was taken out of man. And for this reason, a man will leave his father and his mother and be united to his wife, and they will become one flesh." The blessings of Eden have long ago been lost from this life, and only marriage has been handed down to us today. But it really is true that in this God-ordained, God-given institution, a man and a woman can find a bit of heaven on earth. It was at a wedding feast in Cana of Galilee where Jesus was glorified when he performed his very first miracle by turning the water into wine. And the Apostle Paul, by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit of God, says that marriage is something that is to be honored among all men. Justin, in Ephesians chapter 5 and verse 25, Paul says this to husbands. "Husbands, love your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her." You don't have to be a Greek scholar to know that the love that Paul is writing about there is the agape love, the love of God. And the reason why you can know that is because he says for husbands to love their wives just as Christ loved the church. That's the sacrificial love that God had for us all. And that's the love that Paul calls upon husbands to have for their wives. And that's also the love that's written about in 1 Corinthians 13, what we call the love chapter. I want to read you from that chapter. Paul tells us, by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, exactly what true love is and how true love acts and how true love reacts. And he writes that love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. Love is not rude. Love is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. Love keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. Love always protects. Love is always trustworthy. Love always hopes. Love always perseveres. Love never fails. Justin and Amanda, if you will strive to have this love for one another in your marriage, this love that will cause each one of you to be a servant of the other and to always put the other one first, I promise you that it will help you to have a wonderful and a loving and a lasting relationship for the rest of your lives. Marriage is not something that is to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently and discreetly, advisedly, soberly, and in the fear of the Lord. And it is into this holy, God-given institution that you two come now to be joined. Justin, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? And will you love her and comfort her and honor and keep her in sickness and in health? And Justin, forsaking all others, will you keep yourself only to her so long as you both shall live?
I will.
And Amanda, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love him and comfort him and honor and keep him in sickness and in health? And forsaking all others, Amanda, will you keep yourself only to him so long as you both shall live?
I will.
The vows that they're going to exchange come from the heart. And the reason why I say they come from the heart is because they are vows that each one has written for the other. And up until this time, neither one of them knows what the other one has written. Read, please. Place the ring on her finger. And you look at her and repeat after me. Amanda, I will always love you.
Amanda, I will always love you.
I will always honor you.
I will always honor you.
I will always respect you.
I will always respect you.
And I will always adore you.
And I will always adore you.
I'm committed to you.
I'm committed to you.
And I will always be faithful to you.
And I will always be faithful to you.
I will be there to comfort you.
I will be there to comfort you.
And I will be there to support you.
And I will be there to support you.
At all times.
At all times.
And above all.
And above all.
I will love you.
I will love you.
Unconditionally and unendingly.
Unconditionally and unendingly.
For the rest of my life.
For the rest of my life.
Great. Repeat after me. Justin, from the beginning.
Justin, from the beginning.
I have been impressed by your generosity.
I have been impressed by your generosity.
I have been impressed by your patience.
I have been impressed by your patience.
And by your gentle and loving spirit.
And by your gentle and loving spirit.
I have come to know.
I have come to know.
Your love and commitment.
Your love and commitment.
To me and to our Lord.
To me and to our Lord.
Today, before our loved ones,
today, before our loved ones,
I promise to honor and cherish you.
I promise to honor and cherish you.
For the rest of my life.
For the rest of my life.
Because I believe it is God's will.
Because I believe it is God's will.
I devote myself to you.
I devote myself to you.
For as long as I live.
For as long as I live.
Will you pray with me, please? Kind Father, our hearts are full this evening, full of joy at this happy event, full of gratitude to you for bringing these two young people together. Father, your word tells us that in marriage, two become one. We don't understand how that is possible. It is a mystery, but we enjoy and celebrate this holy mystery. And we thank you for seeing our need and instituting marriage to help us. Father, we are grateful for all these friends and relatives who have honored us with their presence tonight. We're grateful for the support and good examples displayed to Justin and Amanda throughout their years, the kind of examples that made the prospect of a Christian marriage an attractive one to each of them. Father, we are grateful for all the safe journeys that brought these fine folks here, and we ask that you will give them safe passage home. Father, we ask that you will help us as family and friends to continue to set good examples for Justin and Amanda and to encourage them in the proper path as we have the opportunity. Lord, we ask that you pour into their hearts your oil of joy, that they may be a shining beacon to a dark world. Help it be abundantly clear in every arena of their lives that there's something special, something attractive about them, and let it be the aroma of Christ. Father, we look forward to all that you will accomplish to your glory through this couple. We pray for protection from the evil one, good health, and that they will each feel a strong sense of your presence, your Holy Spirit, in their hearts. We ask a special blessing on this new home, Father. We ask that you keep them in tune with your will and more deeply in love with you and each other as each day passes. All of these things, Father, we ask through the precious name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Well, I don't mind telling y'all, I'm in a tight spot here. I mean, this is a real dilemma. We have one family from Arkansas. We have another family from Texas. And, man, you know, you'd hate to start bad trouble right off the get-go. So I've been told to say one thing, and I know if I do, I'm going to have to pay for my own hotel bill. And I know if I don't, there's no telling what's going to happen. So I've been praying about this. And the Lord's told me what to say. And if the families don't like it, they can take it up with Him. So, by the authority invested in me from the great, is that how you want it? States of Texas and Arkansas, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Justin Beller.
Good morning, life. Good morning, sun. How are you, skies above? Gee, it's great to be alive and in love. Good morning, life. Good morning, birds, sing out your happy tune. Feel so good, 'cause I'll be seeing her soon. Last night, she said she loved me. What a pity to part. I slept with both eyes open, waiting for today to start. Good morning, life. Good morning, world. How are your happiness? All at once I know what living can be. It's life, it's free. It's someone waiting for me, who'll someday be my wife. Good morning, life.
On behalf of Justin and Amanda, thank you all so much for coming and sharing this special day with them. And for those of you who have made plans to attend the reception, you can go ahead and leave, and the bridal party will join you soon. Thank you.
Last night, she said she loved me. What a pity to part. I slept with both eyes open, waiting for today to start. Good morning, life. Good morning, world. How are your happiness? All at once I knew what living can be. Oh, it's life, it's free. It's someone waiting for me, who'll someday be my wife. Good morning, life.